everyone, it's Sarah Beth here, and welcome to my latest Sims 4 speed build. To celebrate the spooky season, I'm going to show you how to build a cemetery. I've loaded up my main save here, and I'm actually needing a cemetery in the Willow Creek neighborhood, so I decided to go ahead and select Hallow, Slough, however you want to pronounce that lot. It's a 30 by 20 lot, so it's big enough to build everything we need. Since it's a cemetery lot, I want it to be a little scary or spooky whenever my Sims visit it. So I went up in the lot traits up in the left-hand corner, and I selected a vampire nexus, which will bring more vampires to the lot during the night, during the evening and at night. And then under the challenges lot traits, you can go with cursed or creepy crawly or spooky. So spooky and cursed comes with the city living pack. So I went ahead with spooky, and that will actually generate ghosts to visit the lot during the evening hours. Spooky used to be known as the haunted lot trait, but when they dropped the Paranormal Stuff pack in earlier this year, they changed it to spooky since we had a haunted lot. And also, I changed the lot from residential to generic. Alright, now that we've got the lighting changed to afternoon, let's begin by building the fence. And I think I like the wrought iron fence that came with the vampires pack. And let's check out our swatches. Let's see. I think I like this color the best. I used that fence by room tool in order to just make a large perimeter fence. And there we go. Next, we'll need to build the actual building itself. So I went under room tool. The main part of the building is going to be 6 by 12 squares. And then there is a side building that is 5 by 6. So I want to make sure it's centered. So I'm just kind of counting them out here. And that looks good. I want a fairly dramatic looking entryway to the building. So I'm going to pick the porch room tool, and we'll want that front entry to be 3 by 6 squares in dimension. I added 2 small rooms in order to frame the doorway, sort of like a large colonnade. And next we'll need to add a small room to the side. That will actually be the entryway to our crypts below. I realized my building was in the wrong spot, so I used the move house lot and put it up in the very far right-hand corner as far as it would allow me to go. And there we are. I think that looks better. Now I need to create a foundation by raising the elevation of the building. Next, we'll need to remove the fence section. So you can do that by double-clicking on the wall, and it'll say remove fence. And that's easier than just deleting it segment by segment. Now we can add our staircase. So I went ahead and went with the sturdy steps option, and it has a nice dark concrete color, which I think will match the color tone that I'm wanting to go with. I made it 4 squares wide. To give y'all some context, I'm actually modeling the main building of the cemetery after the St. John the Baptist Cathedral, located in New Orleans. To make that tall spire, we'll need to add two stories. The first one will be 4x4, and the second will be 2x2, and I set them both at medium height wall height. I also want to make a note here that I'm not labeling this building as a cathedral per se. I want to be respectful of other people's cultural and religious heritage. The Sims 4 is a very diverse community, and that's something to be celebrated. I've mainly drawn inspiration for this build from many of the historical buildings around New Orleans, Louisiana. Since a lot of the background architecture and environment of Willow Creek is modeled after New Orleans, I wanted to keep a similar architecture with my builds around this neighborhood. With that being said, let's go ahead and start on our roofline. I plan on this front smaller projecting roof to be part of our front entryway. So I'm basically reducing it down to one square wide and adding a curve to the roof angle. Now this roof line, of course, will extend all the way back. Let me get the right height for it. There we go. Okay, let's pull that back all the way. And next we'll need a roof for the second floor. I like this gabled roof, so we'll go ahead and correct for the size. Once we get that fixed, let's go ahead and add a hipped roof to the third floor, which will be, I guess, our turret, and size it down. There we go. We can make it a little taller and maybe make it a little curved inwards, so that looks pretty good. Next, I'm going to add a basement because I want to add like some underground crypts to add some more cemetery space. All right, let's add some windows. So these windows are base game, and I'm actually filtering all of my build and buy elements to vampires and base game. So if you don't have a lot of packs, but you have these two, you should be able to use this build. I will also have a base game only version on the gallery, and I will add a link to that in the description below. I'm limiting myself to a few game packs here. City Living, which the only elements that will be from City Living will be a podium and the spooky lot trait. But if you don't have City Living, it should not overly affect your gameplay. Next up, we'll add some doors to the rooms on the inside of the building. This little room on the left will be our bathroom. And I'm going to... Ooh, I like that archway. I think I'm going to throw this archway around here, this room, and then that big room on the side. And now let's add the front door. This one is also base game, and I really like that window element at the top. And there we go. Now let's go ahead and start working on our basement here. Since I'm kind of modeling it after some underground crypts, I basically want multiple chambers, and about four of them I think will do. And we have a little passageway into each. We'll make them nice and creepy. Basically, the general idea is I'm going to put in some platforms or shelving units that you can add like urns and stuff to if you run out of room upstairs. I've been playing this save for a really long time, so I have a lot of tombstones I need to put down. This is a legacy save, so... Alright, oops, okay, so let's add some more details. I forgot to add a roof to the second floor, to the secondary room here. So I added a little half-hipped roof. At this point, I turned on the bb.moveobjects on cheat because I knew I'd be adding some architectural details that normally would not be placeable. So now let's add an exterior to our building here. I decided to go for this particular colored swatch of brick from the Vampires pack. It kind of looks old, and it's got some color variations, and I like it. A lot of the base game brick patterns tend to be too dark, in my opinion, so I kind of wanted like an off-white color. And, I'll need some windows for the second floor. Spire there. There we go. And I guess I'll need some for the third floor as well. And I'll speed that up here just to move things along. So once we're done with this, we'll go ahead and add the roof texture. I thought the Happy Haunts roof texture would be kind of appropriate. Now for that one curved roof line, I went ahead and did like a bronze or a brass top. And then next, I'm going to add the roof trim just to make the roof line a little bit cleaner looking. So we'll just match that. There we go. And let's not forget about the foundation. So I like the stone texture. I think it matches the brick color fairly well. Ooh, and next let's add the columns. I really like this particular column from the Vampires pack. I use it a lot. It looks awesome with like really grand or fancy buildings, Victorian buildings especially. And this stone texture looks really great against stone or brick. So let's go ahead and just add those to all the corners. Next, we'll add a frieze, and again, I like this this Victorian frieze from the Vampires pack, and I chose a color that would match the brick pattern. I wish it was a little bit darker, but I'll have to work with that. There we go. Oh, before I forget, let's add this wrought iron gate. We'll want to match it to the rest of the fence, and there we go. Okay, that's gonna look cool. And then, let's do the flooring and the sidewalk. So, I was experimenting with some sidewalk textures, and I went with the old flagstone. Oh, and let's make sure your gate is centered to your entryway or sidewalk. I like that flagstone texture so much, I put it on the front porch as well. We can finally move on to landscaping now. Let's add some lawn texture first through the paint tool. The terrain paint is located under the terrain tools in the build by menu, and I really recommend just kind of experimenting with it because it can add a lot of extra polish and some more interest to your builds. I've seen a lot of awesome houses on the gallery that just would look even more amazing with a little bit of extra detail. And it's also free, so if you have, say, like a rags to riches challenge or playthrough that you're doing, you can add some more interest to your build without adding cost. So, and I'm basically just painting dirt around wherever I'll add plants, along the fence line and along the foundation line. Awesome. So the next step we're going to do is add the greenery. So I love this part of landscaping. I love to make it really tropical and colorful looking. However, since this is a spooky lot, I stuck with just greenery, a few trees. That one really creepy tree from the Vampires pack fit in really well. I don't ever get to use it that often. I used some of the ferns and some of the larger bushes from the base game plants. Landscaping your lots just takes some practice and depends on how you like your lots to be set up. Always consider sim routing. So a lot of times if a build, if there's a lot of trees or bushes blocking the way, your sims might not be able to access certain items, so make sure to playtest before you post on the gallery. I was also decorating the exterior of the building as I kind of went along the Vampires pack. There's a lot of like cracks and scratch marks to decorate your walls for like more of a decrepit building. So I figure this particular building is kind of old. It's been there for a really long time, so. And just to kind of add to the creep factor, for this particular lot, since you'll want to put down gravestones in the future, depending on how you want to use this build in your play, I kept the landscaping towards the fence line and up against the building. Okay, so I think I want to make this entryway a little bit more dramatic. So there's this really awesome fountain that comes with this vampire's pack. It's this one right here. I think it's a lion's head. I can't tell from here, but it's got some nice swatches. Let's go ahead and match those to the columns. Just to make it a little bit more dramatic entryway. And then maybe some plants there at the base. That's better. That top third floor spire was driving me crazy, and I felt like it just didn't have enough detail. So there's this gargoyle head that looks really awesome. Again, I don't get to use it that often, but you can also use the minimize, you can reduce the size of those, and I'll post a video on how to do that soon. I added a gargoyle head to the side of each column. I think it looks pretty cool, actually. Well, I decorated the exterior of the building the way I liked it, and now let's start working on the interior. So this main room is going to serve as like the funeral parlor itself. Again, I use mostly build by items from the vampire's pack, especially those stones, two-seater couches. Although the wall decor and the doors are all base game. I know there are actually several mods out there that create funeral events or even a graveyard lot trait, so this room would be great for that. And I will include links to a few of those mods in the descriptions below. I know there's one particular one that I myself like to use. It's a graveyard lot trait, and it's by Similarity, I believe. It's pretty cool. You can actually add it as a lot trait, and your Sims will receive certain specific buffs and interactions based on the time of day that they're there. And again, I'll leave a link to that mod and its creator in the description below. I went ahead and sped things along here just for the sake of time. This next portion of the video is just basically involves putting down the gravestones. There's actually some headstones available in the build by category. I know there's quite a few really cool ones that come with the vampire's pack, obviously, but actually we have two of them in the base game. Those are under the sculpture categories under decorations. And I'm sure you've probably noticed these brown patches of earth. Those are actually under the debug menu and from the vampire's pack. And they're pretty cool if you want to make a cemetery or a few burial plots. But I did have problems with routing issues with those, and I'll show you during the playtesting section. So I actually wound up deleting them, which is kind of unfortunate because they look really cool. I used a lot of these unlockable items from the Paranormal Stuff pack. You can access them through the debug menu. They were a lot of fun kind of hiding them throughout the build. They'll actually give your Sims a scared or terrified moodlet and certain buffs and interactions they can do. Besides, they add to the creepy tone to the whole build. Okay, so now we've finished decorating the build, let's go ahead and playtest it. And who can do it better than the Grim Reaper? I just sent him through the build, kind of making sure that the doors were accessible and he could use the bathroom and wash his hands. So I sent Grim outside to put down some tombstones he's been accumulating. He had about 12 in his inventory. All these Sims actually died naturally. I just use him to store them. Again, there were about 12 of them. So this is the part where I found out I had a problem as far as routing issues. So you see him wave his hand. I'd asked him to mourn at one of the gravestones, and I went into build by mode, and at first I thought it was one of the fence segments that was causing the issue. Basically, he wasn't able to access the tombstone to perform the action, so I had him do it again. And he wasn't able to do the interaction. You can see him waving his hand. So I went back into build by mode. And that's when I found out it was actually those debug burial plots. So I deleted those, went back into live mode, and I had him perform the interaction again, and he was finally able to complete it. And this is why playtesting your build is really important. I sent Grim back into the build to playtest the rest of it, so we sat down on a few of the benches and they all worked. And he had fun practicing the pipe organ for a few minutes. Although he did play rather horribly. And I'm sure you can see that he is getting a scared and terrified moodlet. And there are some of the ghoul, the ectoplasm puddles, and he slipped on quite a few. Oh, poor Grim. Let's send him downstairs. Oh. I do actually like playing with Grim. He lives in a retirement home in this save. And I do have him uploaded on the gallery, and I'll include a link of him below if you want to download him and add him to your game. Oh, and he just saw the creepy doll. Poor Grim. Let's send poor Grim further into the crypt. Oh, he slipped again. I don't think I've had this much fun with a build in a really long time. I may have gone overboard with the puddles, but they're easily cleaned. Gee, for a guy who doesn't have any feet, you think he wouldn't be slipping on it. So, I went ahead and have him playtest a few of the coffins. Of course, if you have the vampires game, your vampire sims will sleep in the coffins. Regular sims can sleep in them as well, although I don't know why you would want to. But they all worked. And Grim survived the night. But I had one more task for him to do. And he was going to call forth a ghost. If I remember correctly, I think it was Vivian Lewis from Willow Creek. And she was not happy. I guess Vivian didn't want to be disturbed. I definitely know she gave poor Grim an earful, and he just had to tell her all about his night at the cemetery and the funeral home. And I have included a link of the build in the description below. Here's a few screenshots and of the build, including the layout. And if you'd like to see more of these, please click like and subscribe.